We're getting to that time of the year that we're starting to spend more time outside, and it might require some new furniture, or at least furniture that's made to be outside. You have a lot of choices these days. We thought we'd talk a little bit about that with Clint Drotty at the Sawmill this morning. I mean, obviously, Clint, one option, and by the way, good morning to you. It's nice to see you this morning. One of those options is to go plastic, you know, and do something that's easy maintenance. But if you really want, to me, something that's going to be kind of something that hangs around that you can maybe even pass on to your kids later on if you take care of it, it's wood furniture.
That's right, and that's what we're known for, of course, is the wood. So we've sold some of these items, some of these swings and rockers for years and years, and other things are a little newer, but basically, when you're looking at outdoor stuff, if it's a rocker or a swing or a table, typically it's going to have slats like you see on all these things, slat seat, slat back. If you have a glued up solid panel piece outside, it's just not going to last. So that's the reason for that, so all the wood can move a little bit and give some without cracking. So,
is it also important what kind of wood is used in the furniture?
That's probably the most important thing, and what you see here is all woods that are really for outside. Most of this is number one pressure treated material,
right?
And some is cypress, and some is on the rockers. There's oak and ash, and typically those are going to be on a covered porch anyway, so it's not as important. But all the treated material, swings and rockers are going to have stainless steel screws. And really made to be outside, even at the beach, you know, down there in that environment. So when I see swings and things out in big box stores sometimes that are real low price and look like a good deal, I get looking at them and they're made out of white pine or something and not treated, and the slats are nailed on, and
right,
nothing is really made for outside, but it's a good price. So those are the things you have to look at. How long is it? If you want something to last you till next year, that may be the way to go. But if it's something, like you said, that's going to last years and years and years, you have to have something designed to be outside.
Yeah, and I was going to say, I mean, you know, that's fine if you're looking for disposable furniture. You know, if you don't mind if something warps or the nails pop, that's fine. But I know if I'm going to invest in a swing, I want something that's going to be there for a while. My second question would be, do I have to necessarily stain or paint, or is this wood, because it is pressure treated, could I leave it unpainted and it would be fine outside?
If you can leave it unpainted, it'll be fine. It's going to gray just like deck wood or a fence or anything. But as far as the wood deteriorating, that wood, it's not going to hurt it. Now, if it's on a covered porch or a patio or something like that, that doesn't get all the rain and the sun, you don't have to do anything to it, and it'll last, you know, long, long time. So,
right.
But if you want to paint it to make it look nice, you can paint it, or you can put just a sealer. And we recommend that you put a sealer on anything that's going to be out in the weather, just to keep the water from just sitting there soaking in all the time, and it'll beat it off like wax. So.
All right, so give me some price points, some ideas. For I have one of those swings that has the roll back on it, and my kids and grandkids just love sitting in that thing. You know, it's hanging out in the back.
Yeah, this swing here, we have it in 5 foot and 4 foot. That's the 5 foot. It's $189, and as you can see, all the slats are screwed on. That one happens to be cypress. It comes just like you see it, with the chains put together, ready to hang from an 8 foot height. And then you go up to something like that larger swing over there that's, I don't know how long that thing is, but it's big. That one's the pressure treated with the stainless hardware, and doesn't have a tag on it, of course, but I think it's like $299, something like that. And as like the rockers and Adirondacks over here, you can see the regular Adirondack is $159. The Adirondack rocker is $169. Those are Amish made. All the pressure treated stuff is Amish made. We get it from a place up in Pennsylvania, and they just really do good work. And the way you see it is the way you get it. It's not in a box where you have to put it together or anything like that.
Right. And we would also mention to people, if they want to come by, you guys, if they want it painted or stained, you guys can also do that for them, or they can do it themselves, right?
That's right. We do. We do offer staining and painting on anything.
All right. Sounds good. And we'll come back and talk some more. Clint Drotty, again, the owner of the Sawmill, which is located here in Beaumont on Washington Boulevard at 4120 Washington Boulevard. Call them or go on their website and check it out. Again, summertime means furniture, so why not shop local?